Chan. I'm the executive director of Commenton Arts, and this is a nonprofit organization that we founded about 3 years ago to inspire positive change for our diverse world through arts education and music. Most of you are probably musicians of some sort and know that in music, a common tone is a chord tone or a scale tone that is the same in two otherwise unrelated chords. And I love this metaphor because essentially what we're trying to do through this project is build a bridge between people and find a way to bridge otherwise unrelated things together. So we have four programs as part of Commenton Arts. This is our artistic generated series. This is called the Universal Language Project. And we are really trying to be a catalyst for generating new works, breaking down silos in town here. This is becoming increasingly a multi-art series and very socially conscious in intention. So I hope that you can keep tabs on what we're up to. We have another big show coming up later. I'll tell you about that in a bit. The thing I'm most excited about, however, is the launch of a music academy over here by the bar, which is the coolest thing about this venue. I have some brand new little brochures that talks about this. If you wouldn't mind picking up a couple of these and helping me get this in the hands of music educators and students, this is an academy that we're starting as a sleepaway camp this summer, and it's really focusing on ages 14 to 22, and our mission here is to train leaders for the 21st century through music. So we're doing 21st century music skills and improvisation and composition and chamber music, world music, and we're really excited about that. So if you wouldn't mind helping me out by grabbing a couple of those. So this show is going to feature my good friend and mentor, Chris Stover, who, this guy here, the trombone, who is one of the most diverse musicians I know. He is an academic, a researcher, a writer, a trombone player, a composer, and an improviser, and one heck of a nice guy. So we started working on this show about a year ago or so, 18 months ago, and we're really excited about the ability to kind of demonstrate some of these skills that we're talking about here. This music is classical, it's jazz, it's world, it's a little bit of everything. And so I'm excited to present that with Chris tonight. We help me welcome Chris Stover.
Thank you. sure what to expect with the march and everything happening today, but we have the equivalent of the full house for the number of seats that were set up. It's very exciting to be playing all this music, and for now the second time. We played a concert in Bellevue last night, and really bringing this music out into the world. Most of this music is brand new. Some of these are songs that go back 3 or 4 years at the most, but they're new arrangements in those cases. That last song was an example of that. Not Maps, Not Cages is dedicated to a friend of mine, Michael Gregory, a great guitar player who lives in New England, and who I did a series of things with a while back. And in addition to being a great guitar player, he's a great Facebook poet. And he writes these every day, a little two-line poem on Facebook. And so that was based on one of his poems called Not Maps, Not Cages. So we're going to continue with this song now, a new arrangement of a song, again, a slightly older song called Helico.
Thank you.
Kessler on saxophone. And Paul Gabrielson on bass. This is the time to tell you that there's a small change in the written program. Remind myself what's written here. Proliferations, we're taking out of the first set and moving it into the second set, and it's going now as the third song in the second set, and Afrojada, the written third song in the second set, we're not playing at all. So we're going to continue on with song number two, and this is going to feature Ben Thomas on the bandoneon.
Thank you.
this project has involved kind of thinking about music and poetry and the relationship between them. And even though none of the music we've heard so far has words or is directly expressing any poems in that way, much of the rest of the music from this point on tonight will. Starting with this next song, this is based on a poem by the Brazilian poet Augusto de Campos. And if you look in your insert in your program, if you care to, it's this thing with all the little globes or little ovals. This is the poem. This is what it looks like. And I'm not going to translate this. I didn't try to translate this because it wouldn't make any sense if it was translated, because it's a lot of nonsense words. It's all about just the sounds of words and fusing these words together and taking words apart and putting them together in different combinations and things like that. So it's much more about the sound of language than about expressing any meaning through language. So this is called ovo, which means egg. And this is from Augusto de Campos, who's a concrete poet from a movement called the Concrete Poets in Brazil in the 1950s and 1960s. And this is sort of my interpretation of the kinds of sounds that he's expressing through his poetry. So this is all.
Oh, Thank you.
a good time to introduce everybody here. That featured Katie Healy on voice.
On vibraphone and bandoneon. Greg Campbell on drum set and percussion and French horn. You composers out there, if you want to guarantee you'll never get your music played again, write Pete Wright Hartsburg somebody doubling on drum set and French horn or vibraphone and bandoneon. Paul Gabrielson on bass. Minds behind all of this, making all this happen, and playing great trumpet, Brian Chin. Steve Tressler on clarinet and saxophone. We're going to play one more piece for this first set, and then we'll take a short intermission and come back and play a whole other set of music. This is a brand new composition. This is one of three pieces that we're going to play tonight, based on poems by a contemporary Brazilian poet named Angélica Freitas. And this is a two-line poem, and the poem reads: "Lá embaixo samba que não me chama, pois não conhece o meu nome. Down below, the samba does not call me because it does not know my name." And it's a beautiful little poem. It says a lot about Brazilian identity and existentialism and things like that. If you're Brazilian and the samba doesn't call you, then that's a very troubling moment. If that's where you find yourself. So this piece is called Versus Ale, which means versus me, and it goes like this. Thank you.
um samba que não me chama.
Thank you.